Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Now, we've learned how to name alkanes. Let's put something on our alkane, because alkanes by themselves are kind of boring. So we're going to, through this video, we're going to name these five molecules. We're going to start with a really simple structure. This is an eight carbon chain. One, two, three, four, five, six, there's seven and eight. And so this is octane, simple octane. There are really no functional groups to incorporate because it's just a simple hydrocarbon chain. So it's just an octane, a carbon hydrocarbon chain. Now in this next molecule, note that we have a branch coming off of here. This is the first functional group we've seen in this playlist. It is a one carbon functional group. We know one carbon chains are called alkanes. That would be a methane, but we don't have a one carbon molecule coming off. We have it as a group. So this is an alkyl group. This is what we call a methyl group, I'll probably pronounce it. So this is a methyl group. Now we need to number our chain so that our key functional group, and it's not a very important one, but that our functional group gets the lowest number possible. Well, we can number from this end, and it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or we could start at the right-hand carbon. In which case, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's give our functional group the lowest number possible, the three positions. So this is going to be an octane, and in front we're going to say there's a methyl group in the three position. So we call it 3-methyl-octane. That tells us that we have a methyl group on our octane chain. And where is that methyl group? It is placed on carbon 3. It is that simple. Now, here's another molecule. We have now an octane chain, and now we have two groups on here. Now, we want to number it so our functional group gets as low a number as possible. We're going to now start numbering on the right because our methyl group, we could either encounter it at 2 or the 3 position if we numbered from the left-hand side. So that would be 1, 2, 3. Well, we're going to start numbering so that we hit the branch point at the 2 position instead. So this is again going to be an octane, and we're going to have a substituent. We're going to have two different methyl groups, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's not going to be 3, it's 6, 7, 8. Now we're going to have actually two methyls, so we're going to call it a dimethyl, and if we have two methyls, we have to specify where both those methyls are. One of them is at the 2 position, one of them is at the 6 position, and we have to say dimethyl. We have two numbers, we have to say that there are two groups. It's dimethyl, and then it's simply octane. Note that we use commas to separate our numbers from each other, and we use hyphens to separate our letters and numbers. So that's how we will use punctuation in our names. This second structure, again, we have it's going to be an octane. We're going to number from this end first, so our first substituent, our first branch, occurs at carbon 2 instead of carbon 3 if we numbered from the left. Now we have two methyls again, but we've introduced an ethyl group, and that ethyl group is at the 4 position. Now we alphabetize these substituents. Ethyl comes before methyl, so we will say 4-ethyl, 2-6, dimethyl octane. Note that ethyl E comes before methyl M, the di, and if we had 3, we'd call it tri, and 4, it would be tetra. Those prefixes for the number do not count for the alphabetization. Now, this last example is a little bit of a trick here. By putting an ethyl group in this position, we've actually lengthened our chain. We can now count our chain as starting here, and if we number through these two carbons, we find we actually get a no-name chain. So there's no rule that when you draw these chains, you have to draw them straight across the page and make them obvious what the longest chain is. It's up to you to unravel the chain yourself. So now our no-name has a methyl group coming off there, a methyl group coming off there, and an ethyl group coming off of the 5 position. So this is a nonane. It has an ethyl and a methyl. Let's deal with our ethyl first because that comes first alphabetically. 5-ethyl. Now a 3-7-dimethyl. And remember, our chain is longer by one carbon. It's no longer an octane. It's a noname. So these are ways that we name simple molecules, and we can incorporate alkyl groups, or in fact, any substituent, into our name. They're simply alphabetized and numbered at the start of the base name. In this case, all these are alkanes.